Thank you. Respected dignitaries, jury members, and all the listeners, I'm Nisla Kale, MSc Forensic Science student, Department of Anthropology, Delhi University. Today, I would like to deliver a presentation on the topic Review on Sex Determination from Fingerprints. Next slide, please. So, fingerprints, the science of identification through fingerprints, was known as dactyloscopy and is given by Harold Timmons in 1926. The development of fingerprint characteristics began in 5th to 7th week and is completed by 21st to 24th week of intrauterine life. And they are highly influenced by genetic and environmental factors. In fact, genes in DNA instruct skins to fold in certain manner that will result in this random pattern of arrangement of fingerprints. This will give us unique, easily classifiable and permanent fingerprints, which remain unaltered and yet only altered in cases of injuries, cut, burns, and are usually restored once they are healed. And among all the methods available for identification, fingerprints are one of the extensively used methods due to its non-invasive and cost-effective nature. Next slide, please. Based on the direction of flow of prints and shape and presence and absence of delta, we do have four main basic patterns, and they are further divided into subtypes, which are of nine. They are arch, which are subdivided as planar and centered arc, loop, which are divided as radial arc and ulnar loop, radial loop and ulnar loop, composite, which are divided as plane wall, and composite pattern, which are divided as central pocket, double loop pattern, central pocket, and the twin loop and accidental. Next slide, please. Okay, coming to my topic of previous slide. Coming to my topic of review, sex determination from fingerprints and diamond glyphics, the study can be divided into qualitative as well as quantitative. Qualitative study include pattern of fingerprint, type of minutia, etc., whereas quantitative analysis deals with ridge count and ridge density. Sex determination can be done by means of ridge density. Ridge density is defined as the number of ridges present in given unit area. So all the researchers that I reviewed adopted the method given by ACRI, and sample collection was either by means of ink roller or tape lifting method. So once the sample are collected, they were counted by plotting a square of 5 mm and 5 mm dimension in a transparent film. And the diagonal was drawn through the square. So the ridges were counted from one corner of the square to another corner. Usually the radial borders were preferred for analysis, as all fingerprint pattern possess a similar ridge flow in this region. So in case of right-handed fingerprint, the left corner was square was used for analysis. So while counting, dots were not counted. Forks were counted as two ridges, and leg was also counted as two ridges. And this value, the number of ridges per 25 mm square, defined the ridge density value. Next slide, please. So here I have tabulated the researchers, their population, and their possible inferences. So ACRI conducted his research in 1999 on Caucasian and African American races. He conducted the study on 400 randomly picked individuals, 100 Caucasian male, 100 Caucasian female, 100 African male, and 100 African female. And he found that irrespective of races, if 11 ridges or less per 25 mm square is more likely to be come from that of male, whereas 12 ridges or more is more likely to be from female. And similar studies were conducted by following researchers as well, like OBC and ETL. He also conducted study on Indian population. He also chose radial borders for the analysis. He conducted the study on 100 male and 100 female. And the age group was around 18 to 25 years. And he found that 12 ridges per 25 mm square or less is more likely to be of males, whereas more 12 ridges and more is more than 12 ridges is more likely to be from females. And Rudimero Iggi also conducted the research on, he conducted the research on Spanish Caucasian population, and he conducted the research in an age group of 20 to 30 years. He extended his study to radial, ulnar borders and lower part of the fingerprint as well. And he observed a similar result for radial and ulnar region. He found that 16 ridges or less per 25 mm square is more likely to be from male, and 17 ridges or more is likely to be from female. And Thakur MK also conducted the research in 2018 on Punjabi population of India. He considered radial area for the analysis, and he found that if the mean ridge density was around 12.32 ridges in index fingers, it is more likely to be of male. And if it is 13.94 ridges per 25 mm square, it is more likely to be from female. Thakur conducted the research on index fingers and middle fingers due to their highly frequency in occurring in a crime scene, as they, these two fingers will be used while picking up pen or picking up process. But other researchers extended their study to all the 10 fingers. Next slide, please. And Siobhan, and his fellow researchers extended their study to Thai teenagers grouping from 14 to 24 years. And they extended their study to radial and ulnar area, and the entire data population was divided into three groups, first considering the total data, then a group B consisting of from 14 to 18 years, and then a group C of 18 to 14 years. They observed difference in ridges, as you can see in the chart. And moreover, they also said that with increasing in age, there was a decreasing in ridge density was also observed. And Kapoor and Bade conducted research on Marathi population of central India. So they actually improvised the method proposed by ACRI. They considered two bisecting lines, and the bisecting point was placed on core, and a 5 mm above the core, another bisecting line was plotted, and this position about 5 millimeter above the core was actually considered for analysis, and the square, respective square was plotted in both left of core and right of core as well. And they from their study conducted their study on thumbprints, and they concluded that if a fingerprint if the ridge count is found to be less than or equal to 12 ridges, it is more likely to be from male. And if it is 13 or above, it is equal to or above, then it is more likely to be from female. Next slide, please. So apart from the tabulator finding, researchers also found that the thickness of epidermal ridges varies between individuals. Usually women have finer ridges than that of men. And this was further confirmed by Murray and Krishna et al. They said that this difference is due to the average body proportion of men, because they do possess larger average body proportion compared to female, and thus they accommodate more same number of ridges in large body surface. Thus, they do have lower ridge density. And Chanters found that sex and race difference also occur in finger ridge count correlations. However, the sample, he did the research, it was only for 11 samples. But later on, while comparing the table, we can see that across races also, significant differences evident in mean ridge density count. And Thakur MK, they extended their study to the minutiae as well, and they concluded that males have greater proportion of minutiae in blue pearl wall compared to females. While in coming to arch pattern as general, females do possess larger number of minutiae. Next slide, please. So coming to forensic significance of fingerprint ridge density, it can be used as a presumptive indicator of gender for an unknown fingerprints left at crime scene. If such is determined, then it can reduce the burden of investigating officer by half, and it ridge density is one of the genetically quantitative trait in human population, and it do exhibit sexual dimorphism. And they are also found to be useful in identification of mutilated remains and also in mass disaster cases where we get a dismembered hand. Next slide, please. So this is my references. Thank you.